here.
I'm back! I'll take it, I'm back! Woohoo! I'm back, I'll take it. Wow, what a trip from Cornwall that was.
He's back.
Yes!
Can you tell?
Much better. Yeah, come on, Andy, where are we going?
I don't know, but wherever you've been, I want to go. It seems it sounds good.
I'm a bit high tonight.
I know this. I noticed.
So anyway, Andy, thanks for looking after the studios and everything that's been going on and everything.
I think I managed quite well.
You did really well, and thanks to Kate as well. Kate, thank you.
She's very good, isn't she?
Brilliant, yeah, brilliant. Yeah. She's watching later, I think.
She's actually watching now.
Oh, wow, it's just so different to be back here, you know, in a different environment of A4 Studios, but...
Slightly different.
Oh, yeah, but it's much better.
Not noticeable, but things are different here. We've shifted a little bit, but not far.
No, but it's better, because we can do handstands in this one.
Can we?
Because we can fly a kite. And you...
Can we?
Yeah, not in our other studio, but anyway.
Well, I'm not.
No.
How did you find that out, then?
What?
That you could do handstands in here. Like, is there something going on in here? not telling me that.
No, I'm just saying it because it was a small studio, but this one we can move about at the moment.
Oh, I dread to think what that entails. So, anyway, hi, Altrincham. How are you doing? What have you been up to?
Altrincham's been busy this week, especially with other things that have been going on.
It has.
You know, especially today with Remembrance Day. Have you got a poppy on?
You've got a poppy. I'm populous.
Well, you're not that high.
If that's even a thing.
No.
So how was Cornwall then, Chris? Did you got thrown out in the end?
No, my family's still down there at the moment. Well, yeah, they're staying down there, but I will be returning soon.
They don't have internet, do they? Because you were very, very quiet while you were down there in Cornwall.
I was. That's why I only could do like recordings, so I can find Wi-Fi and download it then. I find it distressing because I can't do anything. I can't text anyone properly. I can't message, you know, the same thing. But especially like when I do Altrincham News or anything.
I have to say, Chris, you've not framed tonight's shot very well. Can see the plug and stuff in the corner here. Get your shot framed properly. You're a professional now. Frame your shot. Tell him, frame the shot.
Well, it's better looking anyway, because when you do, you just stick it on your side. It's nice like that.
That guy with the big nose is better looking. You know what, talking of the nose, you probably can't see
it. Well, at least they're walking to Altrincham's walls.
Yeah, there's a bit of a red going on there, and a bit of red up there. I had a bit of an accident during the week. I was too busy buried in my phone, and some idiot went and built a wall near the bus station, right where I wasn't expecting it.
You can't blame that other person now, can we?
And ba-boom! And, and everybody found it immensely amusing. Everybody except me, of course. So, there you go. So what's the news of Altrincham then, Chris?
Well, Altrincham is having their lights switched on next Saturday.
This Saturday? This coming Saturday?
Coming Saturday, yeah, next Saturday coming. Run by Q103. Around 5:30, but there's a lot of going on during the day. As I'm hosting with Altrincham Unlimited, I'm in Altrincham home at 5:00, or before that as well.
There's all going on. Yeah, Q103 are hosting this year's Altrincham Light Switch On from 4:30, actually. I'm sure there's plenty to be going with. There'll be plenty. Look, do you know what? Yeah, I'm all starstruck that you're back. I can't get any words straight. Shall I try that again? There's plenty going on during the day in the Stamford Quarter there, but Q103 are hosting the Light Switch On from 4:30. Mike Toolan from Key 103.
Woo!
Matt Haslam.
Oh.
From Key 103. And also Brooke Vincent. Do you know where Brooke Vincent's from?
Yeah, Coronation Street.
From Coronation Street. Brooke Vincent will be part of
the team. So all three of them are turning the lights on. That's a bit greedy.
Is it them that's turning it on, or do they have a special guest that's coming down? Because
it was like that one when we had what's his face last year.
Noddy Elder?
Yeah.
It's Mr. Christmas himself.
Well, yeah. Last year was so distressing for Altrincham News. People like here, there, and everywhere, and Andy cleared off, and I had to do live show.
I went home in a sulk, didn't I?
Yeah. But anyway. Anyway, I better not do that because I'll be working with that person on Saturday.
I wasn't impressed. We got let down in the last minute last year. We were told that we could have stage access. We did have stage access up to about 5 minutes before we were going to go live. And it got too busy and we got thrown out. We've not been able to secure that stage access this year, unfortunately. But Chris insists that I'm going to be there and I'm going to help him do some sort of live, so watch out for that.
Yes.
Next Saturday. Is that what time's that going to be about then, would you estimate?
Well, I'm free from 4 o'clock, or maybe just after, so yeah, anything from then, but even through the day you can do something.
Well, when are the lights actually turned on?
Half past 5.
Is it 5:30? So. Yeah. So 5:30, I imagine, we'll be live streaming from.
I'm excited.
And also, it's good to have Joe back behind the camera.
It is.
Even though everything fell apart at the start there.
It just made me laugh. I was like, what the hell? Woohoo!
You didn't get that when I was here on my own, did you?
No.
Honestly, you come in and trashed the joint.
Plus, I was in Cornwall, that was much better. But even still, I was on holiday in Cork in Falmouth. I was on the day out, and I was just walking through the town. This lady comes up to me. She says, "You're from Facebook. You should be in Altrincham." And I thought I was in Altrincham at the time because it's a little bit like the same. But this lady came up to me and said, "Are you? What did she say? She said, are you? I forgot what I was going to say because I'm too shy to say. Anyway." No, she just said that, I don't know. But anyway, carry on, Andy, sorry. I'm just being happy today.
Giddy.
Yeah.
Giddy is the word, I think. Yeah, you're getting back in your stride now, though, aren't you?
Yeah, too right.
With your new breakfast show?
Yeah, breakfast show and walk around, which I did twice in one day. Should have been just breakfast, but I just felt I should do it again. But I'll be doing the walk around next Thursday evening, about 7:30.
Thursday?
Yes.
Thursday. Is that going to be regular then now? Because people have been asking.
Yeah, every 2 weeks. Because I'll be breakfast show, walk around. It's just with these cold months, well, cold times.
Are you trying to take over or something?
No.
No? Check you out.
No, you should just carry on with your Wednesdays and just make everyone happy. Or you can start doing Fridays, might be a good one.
Oh, okay.
But, as we said, Wednesdays will be open for a certain personnel on our team.
Yeah. Well, this isn't what we need to know here. Sarah Rule says, "Hi guys, watching in sunny California." Sarah, have you any idea how cold it is here at the moment?
It's quite nice.
How cold is it out there, Chris?
It's warmish, but you've got to have clothes on. Well, about 3 layers.
I find that works, wearing clothes. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I don't want to go down that road again. Have you ever had one of them dreams where you're like in the bus station, totally naked? Or is that just me? Never mind. Yeah, no, I'm not even going to plant that seed in your mind. Even Joe's smirking behind the camera there.
Well, the thing is though, Andy, we should try it the other way around.
Excuse me?
We should try it the other way around.
How was that?
I don't know. Well, I heard you twanging away last night.
Really?
Yeah!
You see what I have to put up with.
No, but the thing is, though, it broke me plucking...
So what, are you going back to Cornwall again?
No, it broke me plucking instrument.
Yeah.
No, but last night, though, Andy, you were plucking away and it broke me plucking instrument.
What do they put in the water in Cornwall?
I don't know, but this place is a bit high tonight.
I know where you're going with that.
I'm just happy to be back, Andy.
Yeah, there's an unusual ambience to the building tonight, isn't there?
Yeah, but I don't care. I do care, actually.
I'm saying nothing. So, anyway, yes, right, Christmas lights, we're going to be there. Are you? Give us a shout if, you, if you're there and you see us. Right, let me catch up with these comments because they're flying past here. Gavin Critchley, hi Gavin. Thank you for your comments on my live the other week, Gavin. He's in cold London. So London. It's cold down there. And Chris Aki, from a windy and frosty Lincoln.
Oh yeah, we'll get the frost, and if they're getting they're getting frost, we'll get it sooner or later.
Yeah, it's a little bit out in the open down there, isn't it? Is that right? Is Lincoln sort of countryside-ish, or am I just stupid?
Well, Chris will tell you.
Chris, is it countryside-ish, or am I imagining it?
Might be a little town. Village?
I don't think Lincoln's a little town. Well, I don't know whether Lincoln's like, where am I thinking? Not Southport, I'm thinking Southport. No, Gloucester, you know, where there's lots of wide open fields and spaces. Is that Lincoln, Chris? If so, it's a nice area. No, Gloucester's nice.
Oh, yeah.
I'm waffling, aren't I?
Oh, it's good.
It's that ambience in the building that must be doing it. We can't tell you, although I'm sure it'll come to light. It's a city!
Ah, yeah, I told you it was a town.
Bigger than a
lot of town.
A big town.
Big town.
It's a city. Anyway, hi Chris, how are you doing? Gavin wants to know what is happening around the market this Christmas.
I think they're having their evenings open, and I guess, like they do like with the malt wine and things. Like the one in the other city.
Yeah, and the... They have some sort of Christmas markets going on, don't they?
Yeah, but there's no news out on that, and I don't think anyone has that.
No, I've not seen anything on that, actually, Gavin. No, there seems to be a bit of a drought of information there, doesn't there?
Yeah, should bring a bit more out.
So, yeah. What I can tell you is going on, though, around the market area, at the Conservative Club on next Tuesday, 14th. It's one of our pet projects, Altrincham in Bloom.
Oh, I love them.
It's the community, they're holding a community support dinner, raising funds for next year's projects. Just take a look around Altrincham. You'll see the Altrincham in Bloom projects all over the place with little posters telling you what they're all about. So a community support dinner on Tuesday. You may still be able to get tickets for that if you so desire. Tickets are £32, and there's a menu online on the Altrincham in Bloom website, which is www.altringhaminbloom.org.uk. But the menu is on there, but if you would like a ticket for that, you'll need to email info@altringhaminbloom.org.uk. Get yourself a ticket, support Altrincham in Bloom and their projects for 2018.
Woohoo!
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 Yeah.
So Altrincham in Bloom have done so well. I was so chuffed. I was on holiday and getting all this news on what they've done. Altrincham, you should be so proud of yourselves having that name. Altrincham had a silver gill in the finals, in the RSH Bloom finals. And then they got their original gold, well, their fourth gold award, which was brilliant. And it was good to come back to Altrincham and find it there, you know, it was good.
You missed it all, didn't you?
No, but it was on Twitter.
Everything happens while you're away.
Well, it's good.
Yeah, so when are you going back to Cornwall?
Yeah, things that, well, some of our main news that we had is no longer available.
Well, we've heard nothing about that. We did have a bit of exciting news that we were dying to break.
I don't think it's right to do it anyway.
It's dried up at the moment. We've heard nothing of that, so we're still sitting on it. Although we're assuming that...
No.
So it may come to light again over the coming weeks. We never know, but we'll let you know. We'll keep you informed. My Vimto's gone cold. My hot Vimto. That's how cold it is here. My hot Vimto's gone cold.
Yeah, I just realised that with my tea. So,
okie dokie. Talking of Altrincham and Bloom, they're also having a bake sale.
Oh, cake up!
Man, I love the cake!
Ah, you missed the cakes with me and Kate the other week.
So I've had loads of cakes in Cornwall. I was naughty. Really naughty in Cornwall. Wanted Joe. You know.
Joe was nodding.
It's sort of like nodding dog. we just had lots of cake. Lots of sweets and everything. I've just been naughty.
Gavin also wants to know what's going on with the stonemasons in Simply.
Oh!
You posted something on the page, so you have the information on that, don't you?
Yes, Green King have taken over, and it's having a refurb, and apparently they're going to be selling pizzas and lots of like
pasta and stuff like that.
And they'll be opening very soon. I'm not sure the date on that one just yet. But if you want to know anything more on Simply, just look under on Facebook, Timply News. They have quite a lot of things as well. They're not joined with us. They're just another Facebook page. But hey,
I'm very good there as well.
Very good, yeah. That's Rebecca. Yeah. She's good.
So returning to this bake sale, 25th of November. So that's not this coming weekend. The weekend after.
Yeah, 2 weeks.
Altrincham and Bloom holding a bake sale. The bake sales are always very popular and they raise a lot of money for Altrincham and Bloom. This year we particularly need your support because the bake sale is actually being held in the Barclays branch in Altrincham, and Barclays are going to match whatever funds Altrincham and Bloom raise on the day with this bake sale. So the more Altrincham and Bloom raise, the more Barclays will match it, and the more we can put into Altrincham.
Yes.
So that's cool. Well done, Barclays, on that. Thanks for your support on that one.
I think Altrincham and Bloom needs a lot of support. Because there's so much happening. It's like the barrier plants is at the station. They're looking to put more of them, and they're looking to put like hanging baskets around the town, but still,
you can help support this bake sale. Are you a baker? Would you like to donate some bakers? Would you like to donate some cakes? Do some baking to help support Altrincham and Bloom. Again, the information on their website, which is altringhamandbloom.org.uk. Please take a look. Also on Facebook and Twitter, of course. Just give them a search. Well, please show them your support. It would be much, much appreciated. And that's that one done.
Yay!
Where's your notes? You normally have notes. Am I the only one? Yeah, you can have mine. I'll finish with that one now. You can have my old notes. If you can read my doctor's writing.
I can. I've got the doctor's writing.
Yeah, you can have that. We've done that one as well.
Yes.
Yes, we have, haven't we?
What's that one?
What's that one? That one! Should I do that one now?
Yeah, that one's a bit late.
That one...
Do you know, I thought that said, you know, at first I thought that said a certain person, but then anyway, get that out.
Now, this one, this is one of my pet ones. This is A4 Studios, where Altrincham News is based. They are after an Ariza Community Fund grant. What they're trying to do here, I'll read what it says on there. It says that they're trying to provide a disability arts hub and a leisure facility for the community with exhibitions and events accessible to all. To show them your support, you need to get on the Aviva website. The address is aviva.co.uk/community-fund, and you have 10 votes that you can use to vote for various projects. And we want you to give them to these guys!
Yes, yeah. Please, yes.
So, yeah, they're doing fantastic work here. There's all these units, all the units in this building are full now. We have, who do we have? We've got artists.
Artists, musicals.
Musicians,
rappers.
You might be able to hear somebody. There's a music producer who's making a bit of a racket down the corridor tonight. But,
yeah.
Yeah, he's also making something else down the corridor there. But, it just adds to the ambiance.
It does, it does, Andy.
So, yeah, please, www.aviva.co.uk/community-fund. give A4 your 10 votes and raise a bit of money. Let's keep this project going.
Yeah, and the closing date for that's Tuesday the 21st of November. So get your votes in now, please. And also, if you do follow us quite a lot as well, we are returning back to the Radio Wishing Well with Tintinette Mike. Your best mate. We'll be going back there a week on Tuesday on the 21st of November at 9 p.m. But if you're going to, please, tune in on that time, because in case the music actually fails on the live show, because when we did the live show there last time, Facebook scrapped the whole hour of our live show, and I couldn't believe it. There was so much, I said so much myself. I think I was on the ball.
We fell foul of Facebook's copyright algorithm
with the music,
because of the music in the background when we were talking off air. So that was a bit of a bummer, wasn't it?
Yeah,
a whole hour's video down the tubes. But we had fun, yeah. Anyway. Kate, Alternative News Kate, is pointing out that Green King have also taken over the Stamford pub and the Griffin in Bowdoin. They're getting busy, aren't they?
Yeah.
We're going to be a Green King town.
Actually, I think they should take the Bricklayers over. Because the Bricklayers needs definitely a good rambin.
A what?
A good rambin. It needs a good uncluttering.
A rambin?
Because that's the pub that takes the town down. Every time people go past it, it's like you just want to, ignore it.
You're not a fan then?
No.
No, I can't say I've been in there recently.
No, it's not. It just needs a bit more bump in there. It needs a bit more young people and, well, not young, but, maybe a wine bar, maybe. Another tavern on the green, maybe. Where Jordan Drinkwater is at the moment doing an open mic night, and he does that every Sunday from 7 o'clock.
Beeb Tony Morgan says he bakes every morning. Yeah, I bet you do.
Well, if you bring
lifting
us some
them
cakes.
Sheets.
Yeah, bring us some cakes. Gorilla.
Hi, Mandy. By the way.
Oh, Mandy. Hi, Mandy. Woohoo!
How are you doing, man?
I love man. Woohoo!
Yeah. I can't say I've missed you, woohoos.
Well, it's the thing that everyone likes.
Is that right?
No, they don't like you, do they?
Okay, I'll be
right. I love this guy's like, whatever.
I'm not talking to you now. No, right, do it yourself.
You know what I mean? He's just a big lump. Right, I can work better now without him. Oh no. Well, anyway, now we can just Andy needs to start being happy. Come on, get rid of that big nose of yours.
I don't come here for this abuse. There's other places I can go for abuse.
Yeah, we know that one. With that bag.
Hey, listen, if I didn't have such a big nose, can you imagine how much damage I'd have done there when I walked into that wall? It took most of the impact, that big nose. So,
Concord!
It did me a favour there. I've not heard that since I was at school.
Concord? Is that
what
people used to call it?
That was my nickname.
Oh, no.
That was my nickname.
No, it's not a nice name, is it?
No.
I think they should bring Concord back. What a lovely playing that is. We should have been there, in September, but people that get back to us being arseholes. Sorry.
Gavin, where are you based? Where is this? Or are you talking, because I know you were having a little conversation with somebody else on the page. If you're asking about us, we're based at A4 Studios, which is in Altrincham, just outside the town centre.
Yeah, just past the old mill. It used to be Trefford's Perkins building, but yeah. And then it was empty for 10 years, and then A4 Studios, the guys... It's called A4 Artists.
You see, I'm not sure now whether people are actually talking to us or having a conversation amongst themselves. But
well, that's what you said ages ago.
Either way,
it was good.
Ian McCulloch says, "Think I spotted you in Bowdoin Vale, traitor." That's not Altrincham. Must be talking about you there, buddy.
Well, that's where I live, mate. If you don't like it, move on.
Bowdoin Vale's Altrincham. It is. Sounds tingly.
Yeah, Bowden's, yes, differently, you see.
Tingly, Altrincham, Cheshire.
Yeah?
Yeah, Bowden Vale, Altrincham, Cheshire. It's an Altrincham address, I guess. That's it. It's that ambience getting to me. It's an Altrincham address.
Oh, God, yeah, we've got to do something about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely a bit much, but anyway, people have sorted it, thank you for that. What's that?
Well, even now, Ian's insisting that it's not Altrincham.
Well, it's definitely not Trafford or Stretford or Manchester or definitely, you know.
So, what is Bowden Vale if it's not Altrincham?
It's just Cheshire, I guess. It probably comes under the Cheshire border, but even still, it doesn't come under Trafford like Templey does.
Well, maybe he's right then. Maybe you are a traitor.
Can't help that, but I work for Altrincham News. That's me. I work in sale. I do actually work in sale. It's cool.
Okay. Okay. Anyway, related to something I was saying earlier, related to Altrincham and Bloom, are Altrincham. Let's talk about them.
Oh, yeah, the last little pick of the year. It's got to be a big one, guys. Please help.
They desperately want volunteers to help out with this last litter pick of 2017, which is Sunday the 19th of November. That's between 1 and 3 o'clock, but you need to pre-register to take part in this litter pick, presumably insurance purposes and things like that. And you can contact Sarah W at raltringham.org. The Honourable Sarah W. She has a title, the Honourable Sarah W. Fancy that? I've forgotten about that.
I think we need to get Sarah from Ulster and Bloom in our studio.
The Honourable Sarah W, yeah. So please show them your support if you'd like to take part in that litter pick, Sunday 19th of November, 1 till 3 o'clock in Altrincham Town Centre. Register via sarahw at raltringham.org. Hi, thank you.
Oh yes, I know, yes. The Trafford Council actually owns Bowden as well, so yeah, I understand that one.
Alright, okay then, so it's not Altrincham then. Is that what we're saying?
I need to move out. I need to move back
to Altrincham. Yeah, you have to move. How many times have you moved recently?
I've moved.
You moved from there to there to there, haven't you?
I've moved 4 times in the past 2 years. Mm. But even still, it was
evidently not far.
That condition, like we've got in this building tonight. That is one condition why I moved on to one bill, another one.
Oh, that you mean that ambulance?
Yes.
Right.
And then from the other place, I moved to Timperley, then Timperley to Sale, and then Timperley to Bowden Vale.
Yeah, okay. But I still stand by my assertion that Bowden Vale is Altrincham.
It is. Honestly, it is.
Yeah.
It's near Hale. Hale's under Altrincham, sorry guys if you live in Hale. But even still, you come under the Altrincham border.
Are you dissing the people who live in Hale, saying I'm sorry if you live in Hale?
Even still. I love Hale, but it's like, I don't know, it needs a few shops are closing down and stuff, aren't they? And a lot of fighting.
Okay. Yeah, okay, so. We're at half an hour now, Chris. We don't want to bore people.
No.
We've said our alone, we've reintroduced Chris for all his sins.
Yay, it's so good to be back. I love it. I love it.
So we'll be getting back into the stride of these Sunday lives. Kate, I understand that Kate she won't be with us this week, but she'll be joining me the Wednesday after.
Oh yes, that's the Wednesday I'm off! Yes, I'm joining!
Have you been invited?
Yes, I don't care!
You can be that side of the camera. This is mine and Kate's spot now. You deserted us. No, not interested. You deserted us. No, so looking forward to having you back there, Kate. And you've got your breakfast shows and...
You walk around what everyone loves.
So when is your next walk around? Thursday?
Yes, Thursday at 7:30.
Past 7, any idea where you're going?
Don't know yet. I guess the stonemasons for a pint, but even still they're closed.
Where would you like Chris to go on his walk around? We did promise.
Oh, yes, yes. Funny enough, Joe and myself were there yesterday.
Okay.
At Old Atlantic Street.
We did promise, I think it was just before you went away, about doing a walk up Atlantic Street.
And Rambo's, that might
so
be a good one.
Maybe do that on Thursday, Atlantic Street, like the people who no longer live in Altrincham but are still connected with Altrincham, have a look, because a lot's changed down there.
Yeah,
it's certainly changed a lot since I was a kid, but I'm very, very old.
We're now 50.
Excuse me.
50.
Bye. You're as young as you feel. I'm not that old. You're as young as you feel.
You act about 82 sometimes.
I've been told I look nothing like my age.
Yeah, I know.
I look about 70
years old.
That's why
you're young, Andy.
Okay. ketchup. It's funny, do you know what? I was actually having a conversation about this with somebody just the other day. Ketchup in the fridge or the cupboard?
Fridge.
Ah, why? What's wrong with you? There's nothing wrong with it.
Because when it's opened, it's...
Does it actually say, once open, keep refrigerated?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Sometimes. Just depends where you buy it from. If it was Tesco's, yeah.
Okay. I'll tell you something else, though, that I find it's really strange, and I've noticed a lot of people do it. You buy a bottle of cordial,
yeah,
that you dilute,
yeah,
and I know a lot of people who store it in the fridge, and then you put it in your glass, it's only going to be as cold as the water that comes out of it in the fridge.
I don't do that.
What's all that about? You don't keep that sort of stuff in the fridge.
No, I've never done
strange
that.
People.
And if it was like fizzy, like Pepsi and Coke and all that, and all them other ones, you would.
Well, that's different. You store it in the fridge and put water out of the tap, all you're doing is warming it up. Well, is that just me?
No, it's not you, just you, Andy.
I don't know.
Oh, God.
yeah. Cupboard all the way.
What's
that? Sally Morgan says cupboard all the way.
Is that what tomato sauce?
Does that apply to mayonnaise then?
Oh no, you definitely got to put it. No, you've got to put the mayonnaise, Hellman's mayonnaise. Oh, I can taste it now.
I dread to think what you do with mayonnaise. Oh, you knew where I was going then, didn't you? She started laughing before I'd even finished.
Oh, I just love the feel of mayonnaise.
Right, I think that'll do for tonight. I'm out of here. yeah.
That one's done as well.
Yeah. Woo-hoo. I think we're about done for tonight, Chris.
We are, Andy. I mean, it's good to be back. Really, it's good to be back. But you'll see a lot of me on here soon.
Woohoo! Woohoo! Andy, woohoo! Honestly, the people I have to work with. So. Right, okie dokie then. So, a lot coming up this week. We'll put... links to the things that we've spoken about tonight on the page over the next 24 hours or so. Catch up with Chris Thursday for a walk around. I will be here single-handed on Wednesday. I'm thinking talking a little bit more about mask-off stuff that I touched on a few weeks ago. Since I've left that
single-handed.
I give up.
It's just the way you
it's
just...
like children's television.
What?
This, it's like children's television.
Well, it would be with you.
This is the guy who sat there about 15 minutes ago saying to me, thank you so much for looking after everything while I was away. It went perfectly, thank you very much, Chris. When are you going to come one again?
When I feel like it.
I'm so glad that they don't have a very good... signal in Cornwall.
Well, they do actually in St Ives and Falmouth and Penzance. It's where I live. Well, where my family home is. You just go into the house and that's it. You just like with GRS. That's all it is. They haven't got Wi-Fi. Bath. It's alright, it's cool. But it's good to be back.
So, guys, we will catch you again on Saturday.
Chris
and myself will be back on Saturday. I'll be back Wednesday. Chris will be back Thursday.
He'll be back Wednesday.
Kate will be back the following Wednesday.
Yes.
Jo will be back with us when she can be bothered. Whatever. Whatever. But other than that, I would suggest that we're done for this evening, Chris. What, was Jo going to say something?
She just told you to fuck off.
You can't say that! What time is it? It's not even gone 9 o'clock. You see, you come back from Cornwall.
Yes, we both did, yes. Jo's been as well, don't forget.
As soon as you come back, this Sunday stream goes straight into the gutter. Or is it this ambience that's just making you giddy? Is that what you're talking about? Clown at Blackpool, doesn't he? Do you remember it? It got burnt down, didn't it, that clown?
Did it?
I think it got damaged in a fire, yeah.
I wonder who did that?
I'm the fire starter! Anyway, right, you can have that one as well, I'm done with that now.
No, I think you'll need that when you need to do your notes. Oh, actually, no, I could do the notes, actually.
You can write? People from Cornwall can write?
Shh! Wow, Cornwall. I'm not from Cornwall. I'm from Altrincham originally. Oh, actually, no, I'm not. I'm from Winnieshaw Hospital, I'm afraid.
Oh, okay. I would comment on that, but...
Which hospital?
I was born in Winnieshaw.
Was you?
Winnieshaw, yeah.
Yay!
In it?
In it, yeah.
Man, that's not Altrincham, that's Manchester. In it?
Yes.
Kate? Maybe Tuesday to make up for Wednesday. Yeah, do you know what? Maybe. Yeah, as both Kate and myself were otherwise engaged on Wednesday, so we had to make do with the pre-recording.
We all know where you went, Andy.
Right, okay. We'll see, but either way, I'll be back Wednesday. Now, you don't want to know what he's doing over there. I tried not to look, but he was just in the corner of... Right. If anybody would like to donate to buy Chris a ticket back to Cornwall, I, for one, would be eternally grateful.
Well, but Altrincham News won't be standing up without me. Look at all the posts that I put up and we get so many likes, and then when you put it, it's like, oh no. You've got to be up for it, Andy.
Chris Saki Atkinson was born in Sunderland Hospital. That's no longer there. I remember that. I bet you don't, because you're not old like me.
No, you're 53.
I'm not. Oh, no, you know what, yeah, no.
You're just an old fart.
I'm not that old.
I know how old you are, it's okay.
Not quite that old, but old. You're as old as you feel.
Yeah. Yeah, we know that one, Andy. We found that out that last year.
God. I'm just digging myself deeper here, aren't I?
Oh.
Every time I open my mouth, you just give me abuse. Anyway!
Yes?
Well, it's 40 minutes now.
Yeah.
So I think that's more than enough. People are going to be wanting to get the Sunday baths and...
Oh, I might join you.
Horrible thought.
Oh, Andy. Anyway, thanks, guys. That was our live show for the Sunday, and Andy, it's so good to be back. Sorry, guys. So anyway, thanks, guys. We'll see you all very soon. Keep watching our post and watch out for what's coming up next. See you soon, Altrincham.
See you soon, guys.